What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. It is me, Call Me Fi. I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day, and I hope this video makes it a little bit better. Before I get into the video, I just want to say that if you are new to the channel and you do enjoy the content, please do consider subscribing. Now, as you can probably tell from the title of the video, today what I'm going to be talking about is the easiest guns to get to Plague Diamond in Zombies. Now, if you don't know what Plague Diamond is, basically it's just the Zombies version of Diamond from multiplayer, so it's just basically Diamond but super bright pink. And of course it has the same requirements as multiplayer, where you just have to get every gun in a specific gun class to gold, and then you will unlock it. Now of course the Plague Diamond camo is crucial if you're trying to unlock the Dark Aether camo, which you can see in the video here. This camo looks absolutely sick, and it is a pain in the butt to get. It is such a grind, and the Plague Diamonds itself are also really hard to get, depending on what weapon class you're doing. But today I'm going to be talking about the easiest weapon classes to get to Plague Diamond. Now, it is no secret that the hardest part of this grind is leveling up all the weapons to max level in order to get all the camos for them. And for all the main classes, like the SMGs, the LMGs, the ARs, that kind of stuff, you need to level up every gun to level 50, and that takes a super long time in itself just to get one gun, but let alone getting that many guns, it's just insane. Especially since the rate at which guns level up completely slows down after about like level 25-30ish. Once you hit that mark, it just takes a super long time to level up a gun. That being said, all of the secondary weapons, like the shotguns, pistols, rocket launchers, that kind of stuff, it only takes up to level 30 to max them out. Or not to max them out, but to get all the camos for it. So that being said, the easiest guns to get the Plague Diamond are the secondaries. Shotguns are easily the easiest weapon to get to max level and to get the Plague Diamond, because first of all, there's only two of them, they're basically primaries anyways, and they're shotguns, okay, and they only need to go up to level 30. So that is four pluses going into it that just makes shotguns the number one easiest things to get to Plague Diamond. Then of course there's the pistols, and the pistols obviously are a little bit trickier because they're just like handguns, you know, they're not that great, they don't do a lot of damage, and there's three of them, but at the same time they're also like, they're pistols, right? So it's a lot easier to use like a pistol instead of like a rocket launcher or something like that. And the pistols only need to go up to level 30 as well, which makes them super quick to do. I did pretty much all the pistols in like a day. I think I was like level 20 something with the magnum, and then like I finished that like the next day or something. Like that one was probably the quickest that I was able to do one. And then of course you have the M79 and the knife, which a lot of people might think that it's crazy that the M79 and the knife are the third easiest thing to do. But here's the deal. The knife gives you so much XP already because you're only getting melee attacks with it. So you're getting a boatload of XP just from playing the game, and it does pretty much one shot damage up until round 10, and then you pack a punch it and it goes up even more rounds. I don't know exactly what it is, but you can go up to pack a punch level 3 with the knife, so that's a bunch of rounds that you can just basically one shot. The M79 was a little bit trickier, but it wasn't even that bad once you get it to like third pack a punch and you kind of get the aim down, because it's a really hard weapon to use. Once you kind of figure out how to use it, it becomes exceptionally easy to use and to get to max level. And of course it's got like I think three rounds in it. Once you level it up, once you pack punch it, you get three rounds, so it's super easy to use. It's not that great, but it's not horrible either. And it's just a lot quicker to shoot off than the rocket launcher. So honestly, M79 wasn't even that bad. It was a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. The knife, super easy, is probably one of the easiest weapons to get to gold. Then after that, of course, you have the rocket launchers, which also pretty easy to do. Basically just get a big train going and then just unload with your rockets, kill them all, get a bunch of levels and that stuff. There's really not much I can say about the rocket launchers. You know, they were also pretty easy, I did them pretty quick. And yeah, that's pretty much it. After that, it's kind of just your primary weapons, and honestly, they're all pretty hard. They take a lot of time because you have to get them all the way up to level 50 just to get all the camos. But if I did have to say like which ones would be easiest, I'd probably go LMGs, because there's only three of them and they're LMGs, so they do a lot of damage. They're really good weapons, have a lot of ammo, that kind of stuff. And then probably the TAC rifles, because same thing, they do a lot of damage. Then maybe snipers, because there's only three of them, so it's kind of a pain at the beginning when you have no attachments, but as you kind of level them up a little bit more, you get a little bit more attachments. It becomes a lot easier to use those weapons. Also, Deadshot is going to be like the number one perk to have to get those headshots in, because that's where you're going to want to shoot all the time, is the headshots, because if you're not getting headshots, it's going to take you like 2-3 shots of the sniper to kill a zombie, and that is just a pain, and nobody wants to deal with that. Then, of course, you got your ARs and your submachine guns. I did the SMGs first. I don't know why. It was probably the longest class that I've done. I haven't finished ARs yet. I'm pretty much done the ARs, but for the most part, I still got a couple things left to do. But, yeah, submachine guns, super difficult. Took me so long to do. I pretty much went until the end of the first double XP it took me, so it was a while. Anyways, guys, that's basically it. I just wanted to talk about the Plague Diamond camos, the hardest ones to get, the easiest ones to get, because I know a lot of people are trying this grind every day, you know, new people, they don't really know what they're expecting. So this is kind of what the video is about. It's just basically saying, like, these are the easiest, these are the hardest, so make sure to keep that in mind when you do it. I hope this video is helpful for you guys. This grind is tough, I'm not going to deny that. It is long, it is strenuous, it's tedious, but guys, it is so worth it. Just look at this video, that camo is absolutely sick, it's stunning, I love it. My favorite camo that I've ever had, probably my favorite Dark Matter camo, if I'm being honest. It's absolutely amazing. I think it blows the Dark Matter Ultra out of the water, but I'm obviously a little biased, you know, I am a Zombies player. But yeah, if you guys did enjoy the video, if you found it helpful, please do consider subscribing, guys. It means a lot to me. Recently hit 250, and that is amazing. Also, if you are starting the new camo grind, make sure to check out my previous video, which is basically just me talking about the easiest way to gain XP in the game. It's super helpful, and I hope that you guys get something out of it. Anyways, guys, thank you so much, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.